डियर स्टूडेंट वेलकम बैक टू डॉक्टर श्रीकंत फार्मेसी चैनल। प्लीज़ लाइक शेयर सब्सक्राइब एंड हिट द बेल आइकन फॉर द लेटेस्ट फार्मेसी वीडियो। सो टुडे आई केम विथ अ टॉपिक दैट इज एन इंट्रोडक्शन ऑन ड्रग मेटाबॉलिज्म। इन अर्लियर माई वीडियोज आई एक्सप्लेन्ड इन डिटेल दी अब्सॉर्प्शन प्रोसेस एज वेल एज द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन प्रोसेस। सो इन दिस क्लास वी आर एनलाइटिंग दी इंट्रोडक्शन टू मेटाबॉलिज्म, दैट इज एन the four parameters are there na, absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. So in this class we are enlightening the third pharmacokinetic kinetic parameter, that is metabolism, how the drug will be metabolizing. Okay, what are the importance are there, okay, we are discussing in this class. So first of all, any pharmacological action, that is an onset of action of any of the drug when administered to our body, mainly two important parameters are there. One is an absorption, another one is an distribution. So once the when you administered from the site of administration to reach the blood circulation, that is another very very much important. How much fast it is getting into the blood circulation is directly proportional to the pharmacological action. And simultaneously, when the drug is available into the systemic circulation, the next most important is that the distribution. Okay, so without binding or less binding of drug to the binding agent, so thereby what happen, that is also the major important for the pharmacological action. If the drug is having the lipophilic nature, it's have the good absorption, and if a drug is having the lipophilic nature, the distribution is also faster. And if the protein binding or binding is less, then the distribution of drug from the blood to the tissue is also faster. Okay, so that is why any pharmacological action is mainly depend upon the one is an a drug absorption, another one is an a distribution. Next, what is an a duration and intensity of a action. So mainly this duration and intensity is mainly depend upon the tissue redistribution of the drug. Means as I told that the passive mechanism will be across us, the drug concentration in the blood plasma and the tissue is mainly important. If no binding is there, the drug will be goes to the tissue. When the concentration is equal, the drug will be distributed tissues as well as the blood will be normal. But if the concentration gradient occurs or the binding is occurs, the variation in the concentration on either side. So that is why the redistribution is another important criteria for the drug from the blood to the tissues. So more the redistribution, the more will be the duration. And next one is the rate of removal of the drug from the body, that is called as an elimination. Because how much of drug is present in our body, that is directly influences the duration of the particular drug and also the pharmacological action of the drug. Once the drug is removed from our body in an irreversible manner, so that is called as an elimination. So at that time the duration will be stops. Okay, so let me discuss what is the meaning of the exact elimination. Elimination is nothing but irreversible loss of drug from the body, means the drug is coming from our body, coming out of from the body. So that is called as an irreversible loss of a drug distribution from the body. In case of distribution, drug is an a reversible. Drug is an a reversible, whereas elimination, it is an a irreversible process. Because in distribution, it is an a reversible. Hence, the based on concentration, drug will be moving from the blood to tissue and tissue to blood. So, whereas in this case, elimination, the drug once it is removed from the body, won't have any its a pharmacological action. So majorly the elimination process occurs in two process that we called as one as a biotransformation, another one we called as an excretion. Biotransformation and excretion. Excretion is nothing but completely removal from the body, whereas biotransformation is nothing but chemical transfer from one form to another form. So the other word which is called as a biotransformation is nothing but it is nothing but the metabolism. Okay, so the major organ for metabolism is liver. As we know that the majority of the enzymes, majority of the the quantity of the different enzymes which are secreted by the liver. So that is why it is called as a liver is a major organ. So liver contains the or liver produces the number of varieties of enzyme which is essential for converting the one form to another form. And the quantity which is present, which are producing by the liver is a very, very high. Hence, the major metabolism will be taken through the liver only. So other than the liver is also metabolizing organs are there, though are called as an extrahepatic metabolism. So other than liver. So what are the needs for the drug biotransformation? Why it is needed? What is an importance of metabolism in our body? Okay, so that we are going to discuss. So all chemicals are nutrient, means whatever we are inhaling or swallowing or ingesting are the nutrients, because some are the chemical substances which are inhaled or ingested are entering into our body by virtue of its lipophilicity. Hence, those are called as a xenobiotic. Xenobiotics are the foreign substances or any the chemical substances which will be entering into our body, or sometime neededly we are administering the as a dosage form into our body. So those with the virtue of its lipophility, they will be entering into the body, and absorption, distribution, and also it will comes at the stage will be metabolism will be comes. So the drugs which are lipophilic nature, they have the good absorption and good distribution, and only the hydrophilic drugs are excretion. Interesting point is that the drug is a good nature is required when the drug is a lipophilic or important for the absorption, lipophilic is important for the distribution. When come across the excretion or the excretion or removal from the drug from body, majorly the drug should contain a good hydrophilic in nature, means it's a soluble and it's a water soluble, and it is an ionized or polarized, and it is converted into hydrophilic. So the interesting is, as I told, good excretion is mainly depend upon the good hydrophilic nature, and through the renal, that is a major organ for the excretion of the any drug, that may be metabolite or or the drug itself will be eliminating from the body. So therefore, because of lipid solubility, commonly passively reabsorbed in the renal tube. Hence, what is our conclusion is that any drug which is administered through our body, it has to be removed in a hydrophilic nature. More the hydrophilic, the faster will be the excretion. And if the drug is not excreted from our body, so the drug will become as an accumulation, and as it become as a toxic to our body. Hence the metabolism and excretion is a major important for the drug has to be removed from our body. So that is why the biotransformation is plays the important role. So to prevent the metabolic system, the drugs which are present as a water insoluble or the lipophilic in nature or non-polar nature, they have to be changed into water soluble as well as the hydrophilic as well as the non-polar to polar. So then only excreted easily by the kidneys and poorly reabsorbed. So if the drug is remain as a lipophilic in nature, so reabsorption will be takes place continuously. So there is no question of excretion from that foreign substance from the body to external output. So hence any drug, it has to be reduce the reabsorption of by the kidney. So in other words, you have to make the lipophilic into hydrophilic drug. So that is another important criteria to be considered. So very common example, benzoic acid. So if you have benzoic acid is given to a patient, it is unable to excrete from the excretor absorber. Because of the lipophilic nature, this benzoic acid is metabolized into metabolite as a hippuric acid. So this hippuric acid 2 to 3 times faster the water soluble when compared to the benzoic acid, and thereby the excretion will be takes place. So depending upon the drugs, lipophilic, hydrophilic, highly lipophilic, polar, water soluble, the excretion will be takes place. So anyhow, any drug which is needed for absorption and distribution, it should be lipophilic, and excretion is an hydrophilic. So overall conclusion is that optimum has to be selected. Hydrophilic, lipophilic, in both it is there, means so absorption distribution and excretion it will be faster. स्टूडेंट, एक क्लास से हमको सरल से इंट्रोडक्शन टू ड्रग मेटाबॉलिज्म क्या होता बोल के हम समझ रहे. जो भी आंसेट ऑफ एक्शन रहता ना, मेनली अब्जॉर्प्शन और डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन के ऊपर रहता. अगर अच्छा अब्जॉर्प्शन, अच्छा डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन रहे तो उसका जो फार्माकोलॉजिकल एक्शन इमीडिएट रहता, फास्ट रहता. अभी और नेक्स्ट क्या है, ड्यूरेशन और इंटेंसिटी बहुत रहता है. जितना देर तक हमारा ड्रग और उसका मेटाबोलाइट हमारे बॉडी में रहता है वो इंपॉर्टेंट रहता है. इट्स अ फार्माकोलॉजिकल एक्शन बिकॉज टिश्यू रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट प्ले. मोर द टिश्यू डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सो मोर विल बी द ड्रग विल बी. एंड रेट ऑफ रिमूवल फ्रॉम द बॉडी इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट. मतलब ड्रग जो रिमूवल होता है ना हमारे बॉडी से वो भी इंपॉर्टेंट रहता है. उसको बोलते एलिमिनेशन. एलिमिनेशन मतलब क्या होता है, इरिवर्सिबल लॉस ऑफ द ड्रग फ्रॉम द बॉडी. इट मेनली अकर्स एज एन बायो ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन होता है और एक्सक्रीशन होता है. सो बायो ट्रांसफॉर्म मतलब क्या हो जाता है, केमिकल कन्वर्शन ऑफ ए ड्रग फ्रॉम वन फॉर्म टू अनदर फॉर्म, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एन मेटाबॉलिज्म. मेटाबॉलिज्म में क्या हो जाता है, लीवर इज एन मेजर ऑर्गन फॉर द मेटाबॉलिज्म. क्यों बोले तो लीवर जो प्रोड्यूस करता है ना एंजाइम बहुत थरा रहता है, बहुत क्वांटिटी रहता है कंपेयर टू अदर ऑर्गन. ये बायो ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन किस वास्ते जरूरी होता है बोले तो ऑल केमिकल्स, जो भी केमिकल्स रहता है ना वो न्यूट्रिएंट नहीं होता, इसलिए जो भी जो हम एक्सटर्नल प्रोडक्ट हम लोग अंदर लेते हैं ना वो जो भी लिपोफिलिक रहे तो वो अंदर चले जाता है, इंजेशन में इनहेलेशन में जाता है. ये जो है ना कन्वर्ट होना पड़ता है, इसको लिपोफिलिक टू हाइड्रोफिलिक होके बाहर आना पड़ता. ओके, सो ड्रग्स विच आर गुड हैविंग द लिपोफिलिक गुड अब्जॉर्प्शन हो जाता है, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन हो जाता है. लेकिन क्या हो जाता है, एक्सक्रीशन होना बोले तो ड्रग शुड बी हाइड्रोफिलिक रहना पड़ता है. इसलिए जो भी ड्रग है ना लिपोफिल टू हाइड्रोफिलिक करने के लिए एक वेपन चाहिए हम लोग को. कौन सा वेपन है, वो बोलते हैं हम लोग मेटाबोलिज्म. मेटाबोलिज्म में क्या हो जाता है, लिपोफिलिक ड्रग इज कन्वर्टिंग इंटू हाइड्रोफिलिक ड्रग बाई यूजिंग ऑफ द फेस वन फेस टू रिएक्शन से. सो जो भी मेटाबोलिज्म अच्छा होना बोले तो हमको क्या चाहिए, अच्छा एंजाइम्स चाहिए, अच्छा क्वांटिटी में रहे तो हमारा जो ड्रग्स रहता है ना इनसॉल्युबल टू सॉल्युबल हो जाता, पोलर नॉन पोलर टू पोलर हो जाता, लिपोफिलिक से ये हो जाता. सो जैसे ही हम लोग किडनी इज मेजर ऑर्गन, जो भी लिपोफिलिक रहे तो वो रीअब्जॉर्प्शन होके उसका डिले होता है, इसलिए हम लोग उसको हाइड्रोफिलिक नेचर बनाने के लिए क्या जरूरत है, मेटाबॉलिज्म इंपॉर्टेंट. एग्जाम्पल ले लीजिए, बेंजोइक एसिड है, ये एक सब्सटेंस है, ऐसे ही हम लोग लिए तो एक्सक्रीशन नहीं हो जाता. अगर ये बेंजोइक एसिड इपोरिक एसिड में कन्वर्ट हुए तो इसका 2 से 3 टाइम फास्टर टू द बेंजोइक एसिड हो जाता. इससे क्या, ये क्लास से आपको सरल से मैं समझा रहा हूँ मेटाबॉलिज्म क्या इंपॉर्टेंस है, नीड क्यों है, उसका इंपॉर्टेंस जरूरत है, और मेटाबॉलिज्म बोले तो उसका इंट्रोडक्शन क्या है बोल के हमारे को मालूम हुआ. थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो.